Hello YouTube and welcome to Heathen Hacks. Today we're going to upgrade my tiny baby TP-Link TLSG1005LP 5-port unmanaged PoE switch that's handling both the power and data for my outdoor PoE access point and CCTVs with a slightly bigger one for additional ports, because I'm going to be adding a few more cameras in the future. Now, I didn't document the entire process of installing the cameras and the cable runs I did back then, because, well, it took a really long time, and it would have taken longer if I did. I'm a one-man crew after all. Let's go! So, apart from the switch upgrade, we're also going to need to terminate an Ethernet cable to connect the switch to the router because the one I've ordered hasn't arrived yet. And these are the things that we're going to use. Ethernet cable, of course. Bought a few hundred meters of it before and this reel was what's left of it. An RJ45 connector, a cable tester, and a crimper. I bought the pass-through version to make my life easier and to lessen the mistakes that would result to a wasted connector. Okay, now this is the one that will replace my tiny baby switch. The TLSG2210 PGS Stream 10-port Gigabit Smart PoE Plus switch from TP-Link. That's a mouthful, huh? What's inside the box are as follows. The power cable, the 53.5 volts, 1.31 amps, 70 watts power adapter, some rubber feetsies, a brochure of other TP-Link Omada devices, the installation guide, and the unit itself. So this is a 10-port gigabit smart switch, but in reality, it only has 8 PoE plus ports, because the other two ports are gigabit SFP uplinks. These are the LED light indicators for power, system or activity, and PoE max. I think the PoE max one lights off if ever the power bandwidth of 61 watts has been reached. Activity indicator for the SFP1 and SFP2 ports. And finally, the power or PoE status and link activity indicators for the 8 PoE ports. The reset button is also conveniently located at the front of the unit, which is really nice in my opinion. There's also some sort of explanations right here that says that if the link activity indicator is green, it means that the device that is connected to that port is using 1000 megabits per second connection, and if it's orange, the device that is connected to it is just using 100 megabits. And on the PoE side of things, if the LED indicator is full green, the PoE is delivering power, but if the LED indicator is just half, the power budget or bandwidth has been reached. At the back of the unit, we have the two SFP ports, the 8 PoE plus ports, and the power jack. Now, before we change the switch, just to follow proper procedures, let's turn off the NVR first. At the moment, I only have 4 devices connected to the tiny baby switch, and those are my outdoor PoE access point and 3 CCTV cameras, plus the connection to the router, which makes it 5 devices. I'm going to hook up 2 to 3 more cameras in the future, hence the need for more PoE ports. So, yeah, click on shutdown. Now that it's powered off, let's disconnect the power. But of course, before we can mount the bigger switch, we have to remove the smaller one first. Okay, I figured that I would just leave the leftover holes here since they would be covered up by the bigger switch anyway. I think this would be a nice spot for it, so let's add some marks. After marking the placement of the switch, now we have to make some marks for the mounting screws. I'm going to use my caliper to sort of take note of the approximate positions of the mounting holes. Then, take into account the measurement of the first mounting hole to the edge of the device just like this. After marking the mounting screw positions using the caliper, I'm going to use my trusty center punch to make them more visible. There we go, let me just move these cables away. Now let's add the mounting screws. And there we have it. Just need to terminate the additional Ethernet cable, connect them to the switch, and we're good to go. This is the cable that we will use. I have already cut it to approximately 2 meters in length. First, we have to remove the sleeve. Separate the wires from the ripcord and crossfiller, then let's remove the ripcord and crossfiller. Next up is arranging the wires according to our preferred arrangement. This is basically how I have arranged all of the Ethernet cables that I have terminated personally. Let's separate the wires, then straighten them up a bit. So, brown, white brown, green, white blue, blue, white green, orange, and white orange. Okay, let's cut them up to have the same length. straighten them up a bit more, then insert them to the pass-through connector. Make sure that the wire combination is correct. Brown, white, brown, green, white, blue, white, green, orange, and white, orange. Then it's time to crimp. There we go. Do the same thing to the other end and we're done. So I've just finished connecting the cables and setting up the switch using its management utility on the browser, and everything is done for now. This is the current setup. Outside the computer room, workplace, lab, studio, or let's just say HQ or command center to make it sound cooler, I have a ceiling mounted monitor that shows live footage from the CCTVs. It's really handy because we tend to order a lot online, and aside from the doorbell, we can also see the delivery people if they're at the gate already. That monitor outside is then connected to this HDMI switch. Hold up, let me just show a diagram to explain it better. As a bonus, here's my network topology for those who are interested. All the security-related devices are on a separate network, by the way. Alright, as mentioned before, here is a diagram of how the monitors are set up and connected. So basically, I'm using two 2-in-1 HDMI switches. Both of them can work on either of the two modes. Two inputs, one output, or two outputs, one input. Let's start with the NVR. The NVR's HDMI output is connected to switch 1's input. The signal from the NVR is then split into two outputs. One that is connected to the ceiling-mounted living room monitor, and the other one is connected to switch 2's input. On switch 2, we have the PC or my system and switch 1's output connected to its two ports that we're using as input. Then the output is connected to my third monitor. The switch basically just changes where the data is going to if using two outputs, one input, and changes where the data is coming from if using two inputs, one output. On a normal day, the live footage from the NVR is always shown on the living room monitor. But if I am left alone at home, I would either set up my old tablet to view the footage via Wi-Fi using its application, or just switch the signal from the NVR to go to my third monitor. Because I don't have a fourth monitor yet. As another bonus, here's a video of when I replaced the cable clip with a bigger one to accommodate more cables. Thanks for watching, and see you again next week. Maybe.